Liu Guoliang, once again, our congratulations, our admiration. Four men through to the men's singles semi-finals here in Paris. First of all Chinese, Wang Hao against Yan An. Perhaps Wang Hao just a little too experienced, but Yan An, what a talent.
首先祝贺中国男队有四名选手进入那个男单半决赛，然后呢，他就一场即将比赛谈，就第一场比赛那个王浩和严安的比赛，王浩就经验稍微多一点，但是呢，严安这场比赛打得也非常不错，就你有什么评价这场比赛？我觉得这场球确实王浩是赢在经验上，如果从场面上看，严安是非常有机会战胜王浩的，但是这就是世界大赛，所以严安又交了一次昂贵的学费。
So indeed, Wang Hao has won by his experience, and Yan An, he played well, but he learned a lesson in this tournament.
Well, of course, if we consider Wang Hao, when Wang Hao played here in 2003 and lost in the fourth round, I think a similar age to Yan An now. Now, what does Mr. Liu Guoliang see in the last 10 years in the progress of Wang Hao?
就是王浩十年前在这打过，然后也输了那个半决赛还是四分决赛，然后完了，他说十年以来王浩的进步您怎么看？
我觉得这十年来，王浩一直是能够保持在这个巅峰状态，是中国队发挥最稳定的一名运动员。所以这十年里头，我觉得王浩发生了一些质的变化。
So Wang Hao is always the top player since 10 years, and he is the most stable player in Chinese team. And I think its change is very qualitative. So compared with the 10 years ago.
Now the second match this morning, Ma Long versus Timo Boll. For me, that was the match of the tournament of the very, very highest quality, and our admirations to Ma Long.
就说那个马龙和那个波尔的比赛，他觉得这个锦标赛里面的最精彩一场比赛，质量很高。然后您对这场比赛有什么评价？
我觉得这场比赛两个人都发挥出了自己最好的水平，和场面上大家看到的一样。我觉得乒乓球呢，如果说经常能达成欧亚选手能够形成这样的话，可能会对这个运动推动啊，会起到是吧这个更高的作用。
As we can see, they played the best in the game, and it's good to say the European against the Asia. If we can see a lot of matches like this, we can promote the table tennis in the world.
Well, that's unquestionable. They are the traditional rivals in table tennis as well. Then we go to Zhu Jin versus Kenta Matsudaira. Now, Kenta Matsudaira, outstanding with his blocking skills, his control, his defensive play close to the table. That must have gained the admiration of Mr. Liu Guoliang, but Zhu Jin came through.
就谈到许昕和那个松平健雄健太那场比赛，然后，他就是说中平的那个整个防守啊什么都做得很不错，就是他的那个推挡啊什么都做得很不错。然后许昕，当然许昕最后还是通过了。就您这场比赛的评价。
我觉得这场比赛是一个矛与盾的较量。我在场下做场外的时候，当比分打到2-2的时候，我已经告诉许昕，我说你要相信你自己的正手进攻可以是吧拉穿对手的防守。我觉得在最后的时候，许昕还是靠自己最出色的正手是吧，还是取得了比赛的胜利。
So I think this game is really between the offensive, the best offensive, and the best defensive. And when they played 2-2 in the game, I told Xu Xin to trust yourself. You trust yourself. You can beat him with your aggressive way of play.
Well, he certainly did that. Now, what about Zhang Jike? I mean, really, he must cause him nightmares and nearly drive him to drink. We have a situation. Zhang Jike loses the first game. He wins the second. I think he's 10-5 down in the third. And then he just plays at a totally different level.
就是张继科，可能就是他那个。 赢了第一局，然后之后有一局是10-5领先，但是好像就对5-10落后。然后就说您觉得他那个怎么看张继科的比赛，张继科的状态？
我觉得前三局的时候张继科打得非常紧张，但打到第三局5-10之后他反而安静下来了。安静下来之后，我觉得在后边那局打完之后，我给他做场外，我说你要记住，你在场上你是张继科，是吧？你必须要打出你的霸气。所以后边两局我觉得张继科完全找到了最佳状态。
So in the beginning of the game, he was nervous, and actually it's when he was 5-10, he was calm down. So I told him to remember, you are Zhang Jike, you are champion, you're the champion of the world champion. So you must play as Zhang Jike. So he did that.
It worked. Good advice for all the semi-finalists. Once again, a magnificent display by China. We take our hats off, we salute, and we salute Mr. Liu Guoliang, the head coach.